एक प्रेडिक्टिव मॉडल ऑन ब्रेन ट्यूमर क्लासिफिकेशन डेटा सेट विच कंटेन अ सिग्निफिकेंट नंबर ऑफ इमेजेस ऑफ एमआरआई इमेजेस एंड यू कैन सी दोज इमेजेस ओवर हेयर एंड दे इट कंटेन टू फोल्डर टेस्ट एंड ट्रेनिंग एंड देर आर नंबर ऑफ क्लासेस विच हैव डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ ट्यूमर बट आई विल मेक अ सिंपल प्रडिक्टिव मॉडल बट यू कैन यूज़ फोर ऑफ दीज क्लासेस बट आई विल ओनली यूज़ द टू ऑफ दोज विच इज़ पिट्यूटरी ट्यूमर एंड नो ट्यूमर एंड आई हैव डाउनलोडेड दिस डेटा सेट इन टू फोल्डर. You can see over here, I have a data folder and inside data folder there is a brain tumor and there are two folder testing and training and in training there are two subfolders no tumor and which have 395 images of MRI images for those patients which have no tumor in their brain and test these. There is also another folder named pituitary tumor. There are 827 total images of patients which had tumor. So I'll make a predictive model on this kind of data. So first of all, you need to there we will do each and every step starting from load data into a Jupyter notebook into our file and then to make predictive model and I'll use SVM model over here and I will compare logistic regressions accuracy score and SVM. So let's get started. First of all I'll load modules pandas matplotlib. If you haven't installed any of those then you can simply write pip install numpy pip install pandas and it will be downloaded into your system. Next, I have used this command. As I mentioned earlier, I have a and I assigned a path. I've created a path variable for this particular training or testing folder. I have a path something like this. Documents AIFeb 2021 and my file name is inside 19th of May 2021 folder here. Project brain tumor classification. It is the same file which I have opened on Internet Explorer. So I assigned a path like this. One folder outside there is a data dot dot slash for one folder outside there is a data folder and inside data folder there are brain tumor and training and for as you might aware machine learning works on numeric data only so I have labeled I have cross labeled this no tumor means zero class and the pituitary tumor for class one and after that I've created two Python list named X and Y. For in X, I am going to append all the images, and inside Y, I'll append the targets of this particular image. For example, it is the I have a in this loop for class for CLS in classes. So first of all, the CLS value would be no tumor, and then it would be pituitary tumor. So for each and every no tumor and pituitary tumor, we will go into this path. This path would something like training inside training like this. There is data folder and inside data there is brain tumor and brain tumor training and training. Inside training, there would be no first. In first iteration the value would be no tumor and during second iteration value would be pituitary tumor. So in order to read all these images I have created an another nested loop for j in os.listir path. So for in order to read an image in a grayscale or you can say in two dimension I have used this 0 bit path and 0 and then टू पास टू प्रडिक्ट पर्टिकुलर क्लास और टू क्रिएट अ मॉडल यूजिंग SVM or any machine learning algorithm, all the samples are expected to have the same dimensions. And as you can see, I'll see the properties of file. The size of this particular image is 630 by 630 pixels. And if I see this properties, and here would be 1024 and 830. So this is not going to accept in machine learning. So that's why I have resized each and every image into 200 by 200 pixels, and I append inputs, you can say features, into X and target into Y column. And afterwards you can check the unique. Of course, there would be two classes, 0 and 1. So afterwards I have converted this one into NumPy array. And if you want to check the sample of each and every class, the number of sample of 0 class and number of sample of 1 class, as we know, 0 points to no tumor and 1 points to patient with tumor. So I have used value counts to check. So there are 395 MRI images which have a positive tumor, and 827 images are those which have not tumor. And afterwards I check the shape. So there are a total number of 1222 samples, and each sample have dimension of 200 by 200. If you want to check the particular image, then you can do so by IM show visualize data. You can check a sample of any index. I have used this for 0 index. So as you might know, sklearn works on two dimensional data only. So there are total number of 3 dimensions, so we have to convert this into 2 dimension. So we would we would flatten each and every image. For example, there should be this number of rows and column should be 200 into 200, 40,000. So in order to do this, I have used reshape. Number of rows would be length of X, which is definitely 1222, and number of column would be -1. It would calculate it, and the shape would be 40,000. So from 1222 samples, I will use 20% data as testing and remaining 80% for training. So I will use train test split, and after doing split, it used 977 samples for training and 245 for testing. Afterwards, in order to bring all the features into same scale, I have used feature scaling. You can either use standard scaler or min max scaler, but I will simply use because there are most of the time for images, the, as you might know, the RGB value ranges from 0 to 255. The maximum pixel value would be 255. So I simply divided the samples into 255, so the final values, the X train value would be from 0 to 1. As you can see, before doing scaling, the max value was 255 and minimum was 0, and after doing this and after dividing it into max value, which is 255, the max value is now 1 and the minimum value is 0. So all these features has bring into the same scale. If you want to learn more about how feature scaling work and what exactly the math behind this and why we do so, then you can leave the comment. I'll make a separate video on it. Then feature selection, but I haven't used feature scaling feature selection into this, but if you want, I have added sell if you want to apply feature selection, but I would not recommend this because we want sensitive information, because if we apply feature selection, then delete some of the features. Like there are now 40,000 columns, and if we apply feature selection, then it would select the important ones, but I don't want my information to lose, so I would not recommend. I would not use PCA on this particular model, but if you want to use this, then this is completely fine, but I would not use this. That's why I have just you can skip this particular step, and if you want to use this step, then simply uncomment this one part and comment out these two lines. But I don't want to use this, so that's why I have simply used PCA train equals to xtrain. Means PCA train is just a copy of xtrain. So I haven't installed because I don't want to use PCA. So I have simply copied xtrain into PCA train. So training model, I would compare the performance of two model, logistic regression and support vector machine. For logistic regression, I have set penalty parameter C to 0.1 and fit the data. You can either use xtrain and ytrain instead of using PCA train, because PCA train and xtrain both are same. You can ignore this warning, and if you want to ignore this warning permanently by code, then you can simply import warnings dot filter warnings ignore. Not show such kind of warning in future. Oops. I should use this before. These lines generate warning basically. Now SVM support vector machine I would use simply, and I use kernel RBF, which is by default, and you can also try for polynomial or sigmoid or linear also, but I'll use RBF kernel, and for these kind of complex data, RBF kernel perform really good. It is being trained, and afterward I would check the score of this particular model, SVM and logistic regression, and it is under processing. We have to wait for a minute or minutes. Oh, it's completed. Evaluation. First of all, I would check the score of logistic. As you can see, the training score of logistic regression are 1 and the testing are 0.95. It clearly saying that this model overfits the data. Training score is exactly 1 and the testing are 0.95. There is 0.05 gap between those two scores. So it overfit the data. And if you want to use grid search CV, then you can also use those grid search CV in order to select best model and in order to select the best parameter of particular model. Or alternatively, you can use hit and run method. And similarly, I would evaluate SVM model as well. And it is under processing. Training score for SVM are 0.99 and testing are 0.96. it seems better than logistic regression. I further use this one's SVM model. So if you want to check where prediction is not equals to actual label, then you can use np.where method. So there are in those indexes prediction is not accurate. You can say model has misclassified the data, misclassify the sample if you want to check. If you want to check 36, then it predict as 0, but actual label at 36 index is 1. If you want to check this by visualizing the data, then you can do so. I have created a dictionary to decode this. For 0, I have used no tumor, and for 1, I would like to write positive tumor. So I have read all these. As you can see, I have trained this particular model on training data, which was on training folder, and now I am applying testing or unseen data to this model, and I would like to check the performance of this particular model on unseen data, and I would write this. First of all, I'll check for no tumor, and I have trained this model into this data, training data, but now I am testing its performance by testing data. And firstly, I would put the images of no tumor, and I'll check the labels whether it is performing well or not, and afterwards I would like to check for these images. So I have read first 16 firstly for tumor, the patient, those patient which haven't have no tumor in their brain. No, I would read first 9 images and CV2 dot. I have used a subplot to plot all these images into one go, and I'm read, and I have used each and every step I prepared this deployment data, this testing data, exactly same as we did while training. So I have resized into 200 by 200 pixel, then I have reshaped into rows, one row, and 40,000 columns, then feature scaling and predict, and after predict the label would be P, and it would be 0 and 1. For in order to decode this, I have used this dictionary. 0, if it would be 0, then the label prediction would be no tumor. For class 1, the prediction would be positive tumor. And to put this title onto those graphs, those plots, you can use title method. As you can see, it renders 100% accuracy. I have read the images of no tumor, and it gives the 100% accuracy on this specific data set. You can check for multiple images as well. Now on the next shell, I have checked for first 16 images of testing data for the brain which had tumor. So I have used 4x4 plot in order to plot 16 images, and same those steps, and to put the label, and if there you would see that, however, there is not 100% accuracy, but overall the accuracy is pretty good. There are positive tumor, and for there are certain classes like this, it said no tumor, but it actually has tumor, and for these two classes as well. But I hope you understood all the process. You can choose another data set, or you can choose multiple. If you provide multiple samples, or you can tune the parameters or you chose another model, then this performance could be changed. This score can go up or can also go down. So I hope you understood all the process of how to make a predictive model on a data set which containing image, and you can use this for any of images data set. It can be it can also be for face classification, for tuberculosis disease, or any kind of data. Thank you so much. If you like this video, then please subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.